Hello, my dear students, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is Conceptual Knowledge. So this is Shabbar Kazmi, and here again I am in front of you people with the new topic. And today we are going to discuss the problems. We are going to solve the problems on the chapter that is from the chapter that is areas of parallelograms and triangles of class 9th maths. Okay, so I hope so that you people will understand all the problem discussions which I am going to discuss today. So without wasting any time, just let us start. So today I am going to discuss the problems of exercise 9.2. So let us start our discussions. Okay, so I am going to start the problem discussion from question number as you can see. So first let me read out the question, and for you people, just to save the time, I had already drawn the picture of this question, and the question is saying, I'm going to read the question now. In the question there is no picture given, diagram given, so we need to draw the diagram by ourselves. So I'm reading the diagram question first, and then I'll make you understand how to draw the diagram also. So the question says, if E, F, G and H respectively the midpoints of the sides of a parallelogram ABCD, show that area of EFGH, okay, area of EFGH, it means the the quadrilateral which is going to be formed with the by joining these midpoints EFGH. So the area of that particular quadrilateral, we are not sure about that this quadrilateral is going to be what, so let's not talk about that. Is equals to the half of area of parallelogram ABCD. So this is the question. The question is saying this. So first, to save the time, I just already drawn the parallelogram ABCD, and in that I had shown the midpoints E, F, G, H. Now this quadrilateral is going to be equal to, its area is going to be equal to the half of the parallelogram ABCD. So I'm going to start the solution now. So first I'll write the given thing, and then what to prove, and then if there any way the construction is required, then I'll do that, okay. And then before starting the proof, I just first of all discuss with you all that how to prove verbally, and then I'll just start the proof, okay. So I'm going to write the given thing, okay. So before starting the solution, it means the proof, we need to write the given thing. So to save the time, I had already written all the things. That is a parallelogram ABCD in which E, F, G and H are the midpoints of the sides of the parallelogram ABCD respectively. Now what to prove, I am writing this. It means I had already written that also, that area of quadrilateral. We can write over here quad also, and if not written, then no issues. So area of quadrilateral E, F, G is equal to half area of parallelogram ABCD. Now next thing is what? That what we need to do next. Okay. Okay, so now after to prove what it means, what we are going to do in this so that we can get our result, the construction. So you don't have to think much, you simply construct or you join simply HF. Okay, so when you join HF, so then you get a condition in quadrilateral, you see quadrilateral ABFH. So this quadrilateral is going to be a parallelogram, and how it is going to be a parallelogram, see, I'm showing you AD is equal to BC, so and H and F are the midpoints, so obviously we can show that AH is equal to half of AD and BF is equals to half of BC. It means AH is equal to BF, as well as since AD is parallel to BC, so we can write AH is parallel to BF. So in quadrilateral ABFH, two opposite sides are parallel and equal, so we can say easily that this is a parallelogram. And in this parallelogram, see, triangle HEF, triangle HEF is on the same base in which the quadrilateral ABFH is drawn. So the two, one parallelogram and the another triangle is on same parallelogram, but and on within the same parallel lines. So we can say that area of triangle HEF is equals to half area of parallelogram ABFH. Similarly, we can write area of triangle HFG is equals to half area of parallelogram HFGCD. Okay, So once we had done this, and now we can add both the equations and we'll get our result. So that only I'm going to do for you people, okay? So let us start our proof now. Okay, so now to save the time, I had done already all the proof, and now I'm going to explain it in front of you. So see here, AD is equals to BC. You can see the figure, AD is equals to BC. How? Opposite sides of parallelogram ABCD, and then therefore AH is equals to, okay, and then we are writing AH is equals to half of AD, and BF is equals to half of BC. See, AH is equals to half of AD, BF is equals to half of BC. Written both the things. Okay, next. Now we had already used that, but AD is equals to BC, so we can write AH is equal to BF, because these two things are equal to each other, and half is already equal to each other. So we can easily get this result that AH is equals to BF. Okay. So now we have shown that AH is equals to BF. One of the thing to make this ABFH as a parallelogram, one of the things we had shown that the opposite sides are equal. Now we need to make them parallel. So see now, since we know that AD is parallel to, AD is parallel to BC. So if AD is parallel to BC, so here AD is parallel to BC, so we can easily get AH also parallel to BF. So that only we have got it. See, so AH parallel to BF. So now in quadrilateral ABFH, ABF, please see the diagram, ABFH. So in parallelogram ABFH, we have what things we have? AH parallel to BF and AH equals to BF and AH parallel to BF. Now if these two things we are already having and shown, so and as proved above, I had written because I had already proved this. So therefore ABFH is a parallelogram. Now we had done our one of the things that ABFH is a parallelogram. So after showing that ABFH is a parallelogram, our half question is solved. Now next is, from figure we can observe that, okay, now just observe the figure, this figure, from figure ABFH we can observe that the triangle HEF and parallelogram ABFH are on same base and within same parallels. So that only I had written. From figure we can observe that triangle HEF and parallelogram ABFH are on same base and within same parallel lines. So we are going to use the theorem, that is the area of triangle is equals to half of the area of parallelogram ABFH. So similarly, the same thing we are going to do within the lower part, HFCD. Okay, HFCD. So the lower part is of also over here. So we can write area of triangle HGF. See, HGF. This is the triangle. So it is also going to be equal to half of the area of parallelogram. So that also we had used. So we are now having two equations, one and two. Now on adding both these equations, so see, when we add these two equations, so this triangle plus this triangle is going to give us the area of the whole HEFG, right? Yes, right. HEFG. And when we add these two parallelograms ABFH and HFCD, so obviously we are going to get the area of the whole parallelogram, that is ABCD. I hope that you people are understanding. So that only now I'm writing. So on adding equation first and second we get. So now we are going to add the equation first and second. So these two LHS is going to be added with LHS and RHS is going to be added with RHS. So half area parallelogram ABFH, half area parallelogram HFCD. So when we add these two, so we are going to get the quadrilateral EFGH, because we had not shown that EFGH is what. So, and we are not even bothered about that because the question is asking something else. So we had shown area of quadrilateral EFGH is equals to half area of parallelogram ABCD. So this is the proof of the question number 2. Now in this video only, I'm going to discuss some more problems. And I hope so that verbally if we go for that, so we can just easily understand this. And if still you people want that I should solve each and every questions, it means in writing, because I had shown the method, the way how to do the problems. Okay, you need to show each and everything. I had shown everything. If you need to draw the construction part, then also that also I had shown to you people that you need to do these things. So almost I had discussed all the things, and now verbally I'll just try to make you people understand about the remaining questions. So let us start our discussion. It means I'm just going to draw the figures so that I can explain it properly to you people. So hope so that you people will understand. If you people don't understand anything, then you can tell me to explain or to just give the solution in writing in the comment box. Okay, so okay, now I'm starting. Okay, now I'm skipping the question number 3 and 4 so that you all can do it by yourself as an assignment. And now I'm going to discuss the question number 5. So let me read out first of all question number 5. In figure 9.17, this is our figure. I'll draw this also. PQRS and ABRS. So PQRS, this is one of the parallelogram, and ABRS, ABRS. We can easily observe the parallelograms, two parallelograms are there. Okay. And the question is saying, and x is any point on side br. Okay, so this is the side br. On this side br we are having any point x, so it can be anywhere x is the point. Okay, now the question is asking to prove two things. Okay, now the question is asking to prove two things. The two things are area of PQRS is equals to area of ABRS. So PQRS, it means area of parallelogram PQRS is equals to area of parallelogram ABRS. So that is, I think, already proved. Now I'm just going to draw the picture also for you. And the next is area of AXS. AXS is equals to half area of PQRS. So that also I'm going to discuss with you. But let me draw first of all the figure, the big figure, so that it should be easily visible to you people, and we can discuss the things well. Okay. So just a minute. Okay. So here is the picture. I had drawn it for you people. So let me just magnify it so that it should be visible properly to everyone, and we can discuss it properly. So this is the question. This is the figure in which we have to discuss it. Okay, the question is saying now, we can easily observe the question. Okay, the first question is saying that area of PQRS, PQRS, this is a parallelogram, is equals to area of ABRS. I think we don't need to prove anything, okay, because we are already having a theorem that the parallelograms on the same base and within the same parallels are equal in area. So we can write this as one statement. From the figure we can observe that parallelogram PQRS and parallelogram ABRS are on the same base and within the same parallel lines. Therefore, area of PQRS is equals to area of ABRS. Done. The first proof. How much simple is this? You need to simply use the first the theorem, parallelogram theorem, and then you can easily get this result. So this one done. That's why I'm not writing anything. Okay, this is very easy stuff. Okay, the next thing is asking that area of AXS. Okay, see AXS. I think all of you can easily understand the triangle. It means easily observe the triangle AXS. Okay, so now this triangle AX is equal to half of area of PQRS. So this is also very easy thing. Okay, how you will prove? No, this AXS is in actually ABRS. Okay, and we can observe easily. Okay, let me just dark this ABRS. AB. Okay, this is the our quad parallelogram ABRS. I'm just making it dark so that you people can understand it easily. So this is the parallelogram ABRS. In this parallelogram we are having a triangle AXS. Okay, so this is our triangle AXS. So we can easily observe the triangle AXS lies on the base, same base of the parallelogram ABRS, that is AS, and they are within the same parallel lines. So obviously we can write area of triangle AXS is equal to half area of parallelogram ABRS. Okay, now one equation we got. Now in this one equation we had already proved that area of ABRS is equals to area of PQRS. So in place of area of ABRS we can simply substitute area of PQRS. So we had shown it that area of AXS is equals to half area of PQRS. So this is the thing we had done verbally and very easily. Okay, but I hope so that many of you will still will have any confusions. So no issues. If you have still have any confusions, so then you can just comment and give me the means you can tell me in the comment box that please sir make the video filled with full details with full solutions. I'll do that also, no issues. Okay, but it is very easy to understand. That's why I didn't discuss that much. Okay, now let us move on to the another problem, that is question number 6. So this is a bit bigger problem, so I'm just reading out this question for you. Okay, the question says that A farmer was having a field in the form of a parallelogram PQRS. Let us suppose the PQRS we are having like this, PQRS, okay? And now the question is saying, she took any point A on RS. Where is RS? RS is here. Let us suppose that we have taken a point A over here, RS, okay? On RS, we have taken a point A. Okay, it's better that instead of doing, just making it rough, you know, why not to make a separate diagram, no? So that will be much better, I think so. Okay, so let us make it. We have done it. P, Q, R, and S. Okay, so this is our, okay, sorry, it is not visible. Just a minute. Okay, now it is visible. So this is our parallelogram PQRS. Now the question is saying that, sorry, she took any point A on RS and joined it to points P and Q. Okay, no problem. You can see on RS she is taking a point A. So let us take anywhere A and join this A with, I'm just doing the rough work, okay, with, so it might be possible that it does not look that much accurate, so no issues. Okay, I hope you will understand. So this is your APQ. Now the question is saying, okay, point RS and joined it to points P and Q. Okay, in how many parts the field is divided? So 1, 2, 3 parts. Yeah, it is very easy to tell that divided. What are the shapes of these parts? The shape of these parts are triangles. So I don't think so that these questions I have to write and then give you people the answer. Okay, now the next thing is asking, the farmer wants to sow wheat and pulses in equal portions of the field separately. Okay, and now the farmer wants to sow wheat and pulses. That means two grains are there, wheats and pulses, in equal portion of the field separately. How would she do it? Okay, now the question is actually the application based question. Okay, at last the question is asking that a farmer wants to sow the wheat and pulses. Okay, no issues, and equal areas. So here we are having three parts, 1, 2, 3. Now we need to show that this area of parallelogram triangle APQ is equals to half area of PQRS and area of PSA plus area of QAR. These two triangles area, when they are going to be sum up. So we are going to again get it like, since this is equals to half, so this only, this two only remaining. So they are also going to be half of this PQRS. So obviously we had shown it that this is also the half of the PQRS and this is also the half of the PQRS. So we can simply say that the farmer is going to sow the either wheat or pulses in APQ triangle, in the area of APQ triangle. Then obviously if he had sown wheat over here, so the farmer will sow the pulses in the area of triangles APS and ARQ. So I hope so that it is very easy to understand. Okay, now how you will show that area of triangle APQ is equals to half area of triangle PQRS? So you don't need to show it, you simply use the theorem, because already we had done it. So I hope so that it is very easy for you to understand it. So since these two triangles and parallelograms are on same base and within the same parallels, so definitely area of triangle APQ or PAQ or whatever it is given, so equals to area of parallelogram PQRS. It is equal to half area of parallelogram PQRS. So using this property, we can just easily show that this is also equal to half, and this, the sum of these two triangles area is also going to be half of this PQRS. Okay. Okay. So I hope so that today's problem discussions must be cleared with all of you. So please go through the video and try to watch and try to understand the things after watching it. So you need to concentrate a bit at least. So without concentration, you're not going to get anything. I hope so that all of you will like my videos. So please go through it and try to understand more and more. I hope so that I'm just doing a good work to enhance the understanding of my students. So please give it, means tell me the things in the comment box also. Okay, thank you everyone. Again, just we'll meet in the next class. Thank you.